Right, Stevie, it's been a while since we've had a chat. It's been a quiet 2 or 3 weeks, but I'm sure there's been plenty going on behind the scenes. Just bring us up to speed with what's been happening the past couple of weeks.
Yeah, last week was a challenge in itself in terms of the weather that we faced, but we managed to get a week along at Michael Woods, a couple of days indoors, and then the rest of it was outdoor in the Astro there. So, you know, we've got a good working week under our belt. Other than that, you know, as our coaching staff have been out watching games. I think I've taken maybe half a dozen games from our game down at Queen of the South. So it's just keeping an eye on opposition that we'll come up against. And then, as you say, you're always on the outlook to try and learn something and look at what other players are out there as well.
Always slightly frustrating off the back of a couple of wins that then we don't have a game for 2 or 3 weeks, but I guess that's just the way it is. And it's a big game against Partick Thistle on Saturday, a team that we've beaten a couple of times already this season, and are fighting for their lives at the bottom of the table as well.
Yeah, I've watched Partick a couple of times. I went up to Dundee to watch them. You know, he started with a 4-3-3 formation, and then at half time changed it to a 3-5-2, and then I watched him against Raith Rovers the other night in the cup game. You know, it seemed a more 4-4-1-1, 4-4-2 formation. So, Ian, you know, he's got a lot of experience in league football, and I'm sure it'll be a difficult game that we face, but two of our better performances have come against Partick Thistle this season, and something that we're looking forward to go and try and take all 3 points.
Particularly that first away game at Fir Hill was a very impressive performance, and if we could replicate that, that would be nice.
Yeah, I think it was a very professional performance on the day. Partick were very good in opening 10-15 minutes, I felt, caused us a lot of bother. We stood up to that, and then we scored a good goal. And kicked on from there. And similar to the last home performance against Dundee, I thought it was, you know, we had a good shape about us out of possession as well. So it's something that we've been working on tirelessly over the last few weeks again. And if we can replicate that performance against Dundee in the last home game, then I'm sure it'll hold as well.
Now, I'm hoping you'll have a positive answer to this, but given with the break, hopefully it will. You know, giving you time to get some players back from injury who are maybe carrying knocks or what have you, and the new boys gelling into the squad and integrating as well. Has that been the case?
Yeah, it is, and you know, it's positive on that front. We did have a few that were suffering from a wee flu thing that was going about, but you know, we're over that. And the injury front, Lewis Martin's now managing to get games under his belt. He played against Morton in a reserve game. Joe Thompson's managed to get some more training under his belt. So, as I say, everything's looking good in that front.
And it's, you know, this is the running now to the end of the season. It's going to be very busy. We've got Inverness coming up at home, obviously, next week. And we're in a decent position. We've given ourselves a decent shot of getting in the playoffs.
Yeah, I think, and again, I don't want to sound like that stuck record, but you're 5 points off second place. Equally, you know, we're 8 points ahead of Partick, who are sitting at the bottom of the league at the moment. So we're fully aware that the 5 games that are coming up in this 2-week period are going to be vital to see how our season progresses, but one that we're very much looking forward to.
A couple of new signings, obviously, in the transfer window. How do you feel they've been settling in? I know there's been a couple of games, but I guess you'll had to spend quite a bit of time on the training ground with them as well.
Yeah, I think, you know, obviously when you're getting players that come in on loan from other places, there's a reason for that. And it'll take them a little bit of time to get up to match speed. That's where the frustration comes at the games, you know, stopped when they did. But as I say, we've worked hard on the training ground to try and integrate them. They're good boys. They've fitted in well to the squad, and as I say, they're happy to play their part come to the end of the season now.
Are there any injury concerns ahead of Saturday?
No, there's a few. There are a few that, like anything, when you try to train to a tempo and, you know, replicate what's going to be asked of you in matches. We had a bounce game ourselves on Saturday at East End. We played 60 minutes. But there are a couple, no ones that I want to go public on. But you know, I'm not too concerned that they're going to be missing for the weekend, but we just have to make sure that we're not pushing somebody. We haven't as many games coming up in this short space of time.
And finally, Stevie, you mentioned a number of times before how important it is, the link between the team and the fans, and how important and how successful that could be. I know there's lots of stuff been going on behind the scenes here at East End that you'd probably like to highlight, but also the the fans between now and the end of the season can play a vital role in where we finish in the league.
Yeah, listen, I said it, the Dundee game, we'd went five games without winning, you know, or five defeats in a row, and I thought they were magnificent to a man. The North West section, I think Jason Cannon's been putting something together over there, and it's great that we can get a connection between the fans and ourselves, because it can only help us move on forward.